Hey, I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about how to analyze your data and start writing a results section for your research project using various Google software, like Google Forms and Google Docs and Google Spreadsheets. So let's start by pulling up a Google Forms survey that I've already made and collected some responses on. So let's just go to Forms. Alright, so these are all the forms I've been working on, but let's find the one that I made. Where is it? Here we go. So you just want to go to your Google Forms that you made and click on it to open that up. And you can see this is all the questions that I've already created, and I distributed the survey so my participants could fill it out. But now that I want to write about the results, what I do is I click on this button up here, Responses. So if you click on that, now it'll bring you to your summary statistics. So these are all your descriptive statistics for your Google Forms survey. The way that it works, if you notice, is it creates a different like chart. Like here we have a pie chart. And here we have a bar chart. It creates a different chart for each question in your survey. So question one was, which genre of fiction do you prefer? And you could see I've got two options, science fiction and fantasy. 49% or 24 respondents chose fantasy and 25 chose science fiction. So it's a pretty even split. You notice if you highlight any part of these charts, you'll get to see the raw data. So here the count is 15, so that means 15 people chose option 4. And here the count is 25, so 25 people chose science fiction. And so on. So I've got a lot of data here, obviously. So if I wanted to include this in a results section, the first thing I'm going to need to do is decide what data I want to describe in detail and what data I just want to, briefly address. So if we take a look at this, you'll see that this one, it doesn't really have that much information in there. Like, I could probably just describe this in a single sentence. Just say, 24 out of the 49 respondents indicated that they prefer fantasy over science fiction. And that's all I have to say about that. So I don't need to include this chart. I don't need to describe much else. That's really all there is. And the same thing could go for these kinds of charts. If you notice, there is a bit of data here, but I probably don't need to go into that much detail. For this one, I could just say 15 of the 48 respondents indicated that they like Lord of the Rings. That's what the number 4 means. So I could just explain that in a single sentence. If I wanted to, I could go into more detail and have a second sentence saying, 7 of the 48 said that they really like it, and 7 of the 48 said that they were neutral, they didn't feel one way or the other, and so on. But that's the trickiest part of this, is you just need to pick which questions, which data you want to go into in detail, and which stuff you want to just briefly address. But for all these ones, I think I could just kind of gloss over them. I have a lot of these, as you can see. So, yeah. But here, these questions I think are a bit more interesting. So let's talk about these in some more detail, and let's also actually include these charts in my results section. So let me show you how you can do that. The first thing you're going to want to do is open up a Google Docs document. So let's go to Google Documents. So you can find it in the same way you find all other kinds of Google apps. Just click on this little grid thing you see up here and you should see it on the very first page. So now we have a Google Documents folder here. These are all the documents you've been working on. If you've never made one before, then you won't see anything down there, of course. But let's just start a new one. So click on blank. Now, to get the chart from Forms to Google Docs, what you're going to want to do is go to the chart that you're interested in, and you should see this little symbol on the right. If you hover over it, you see it says Copy Chart. So you click on that. It says Chart Copied to Clipboard. You go to your Google Documents file, and you paste. So you can click Edit and paste. Oh, well, it's telling me that I have to use Control V. So you hold your Control button and you hit V. There you go. All right, so now we have our chart from our forms here. But you don't want to just dump a whole bunch of charts in your results section. You need to talk about them first. So let's split this into a couple windows. Alright. So, oops. Okay. So, as I said, you should probably address these other ones in just a sentence or two, so let me just show you how I would do that, and then we'll come back to this thing. So for the first one, I could just simply write something like, what was it? 24 of the 449 respondents indicated that they prefer fantasy over science fiction. And then sentence number two could be that regarding their favorite their TV/film preferences, 15 of the 48 participants indicated that they like the Lord of the Rings franchise, and so on. So, in general, whether you write out the word 24 or you just put the number is kind of optional, but I just think it looks much better like this. Like, it looks weird to start a sentence with, you know, the number 24. Alright, so let's skip down to this chart. Alright, so for this one, you could start off a whole paragraph by saying participants were also asked questions about their personal beliefs. The first, regarding the first question, which was the universe was created by an intelligent being, the most common response was strongly agree. With 19 of the 49 respondents the second most common response was strongly disagree, with 11 of the 49 respondents. And maybe that's all I need to say about this chart. Or maybe you could go into the full detail and talk about every single bit of data in there. It really depends on how important that chart is for testing your hypothesis. That's kind of the whole point here. When you do this kind of data collection and analysis, the hardest part is just picking what you think is the best. And make sure you're not picking the stuff that looks the nicest for your hypothesis. That's not the point. The point is you want to pick the stuff that best answers your hypothesis. Whether it supports it or not, doesn't matter. You just want to pick the stuff that most directly answers your hypothesis. And I have a few, and I'm going to want to include some more, so let's copy this one. We can paste it down here. And I'll want to do a similar kind of written description. You know, participants were also asked the question as to whether... I'm kind of lazy, so I'll just copy. Each person in the most I think you get the idea. So pick a few good looking charts, describe them in detail. For the other data, just describe it briefly, and that's really all there is to it. If you ask any kind of demographic questions like this, you probably should have, because it's always good to have that kind of information. This kind of stuff, this has nothing to do with your hypothesis in most cases, so while it is interesting and you should include it in your paper, it does not go in your results section. This would go in your methods section. So in the part of your methods section where you're describing who these people are, that's where you would put this kind of data. Like, maybe this one would be appropriate for my hypothesis, but that's a decision you'll have to make. These other ones, definitely not. Alright, so that's pretty much all you need to do to have a decent-looking results section for a project like this. But there is a few final things I want to mention, and that is, you can also view your data in another program Google has called Sheets. So that's what this button right here is for. So if you go ahead and you click on that, it will create a spreadsheet of your data. So now you can just look at the data in its raw form. And this might be unnecessary for your purposes. You might be perfectly happy with what Google automatically makes for you, like all those charts and things. But if you wanted to make your own charts, if you wanted to edit the data in any way, this is how you could do it. Like, one thing you'll notice is that I've gotten a wide variety of responses here from my participants, and some of them probably should be altered a little bit just so things fit in a little bit better. Like, let me show you what I mean. If I come back to here and I look at this, it says Catholic and Catholic. Why do I have two different kinds of Catholic? That's a problem, and I can fix that in the data. So let's see here. I'm not entirely sure where that problem is coming from, but obviously it's something I could fix if I wanted to spend some time and try to figure that out. But just to show you a couple other things you can do besides just fixing up the data and cleaning things, making it look a little bit better, is you can also do your own, like, mathematical operations. If you want to do anything like that in spreadsheet software, you start by picking an empty cell, you type equals, and then what kind of function you want to do. So I want to compute an average, so I type equals average. Now I need to select the cells that I want to average. You see the little formula down here. So do the open parentheses, and now select all the values. So let's compute the average of Lord of the Rings responses. So I select all those, just like you see here. You can see now it says I'm going to compute the average of C2 to C50. Hit enter, and there's my average. If you want to, you can type, something like this, so you remember what it is that we're even looking at here. And just as is the case with a lot of spreadsheet software, you can also, once you've typed in the formula, if you click on this little box, you can copy the formula to adjacent cells. And take a look at this up here. It says C2 to C50. Well, this one is D2 to D50 and E2 to E50. So it'll automatically update as you drag it to separate columns like that. So that's a really convenient way to just quickly compute a lot of averages in this case, but you could do that with any function. Like, let me just show you one more. Let's do, I don't know, how about standard deviation? That's something that's pretty useful to go along with averages. So stdev, now let's choose the data once again. Type in standard deviation right here. I'm just making it look a little bit better by aligning it. We can copy that over again. And there you go. So now I have all the averages and standard deviations for all these numerical questions I have here. So, yeah, I mean, if you're not really into spreadsheet software, you can just completely disregard all this stuff. It's really not that important in most cases. Generally, if you set up a good-looking survey, like a simple survey like this one with linear scales and multiple choice questions, you'll get perfectly good charts that you can use in your results section. Oh, and just one final note. I know sometimes, for whatever reason, you might have trouble copying these charts, or maybe you want to copy and paste into a Word document. Either case, if you're having trouble copying, just always remember, no matter what device you're using, you can always take a screenshot. So for a Windows computer, it would be holding the Shift button and hitting Print Screen. So now that I've copied the screen, I can paste it into my Word document. Or in this case, my Google Docs document. So let's paste it right here. Let me try that again. I think I pushed the wrong thing. Yeah, so there you go. Obviously, this is really messy. You're going to want to crop out all the unnecessary information and resize it so it fits more like this one does. So to do that kind of stuff, you can just click on it. Where's the crop function? Oh, it's right here. Crop function almost always looks like this, but if you're having trouble finding it with the software you're using, you can always get help for those kinds of things by doing a simple Google search. So let's crop that down. Just select these little black bars on the sides. Make it fit nice and tight around the actual chart itself. And that looks good. But obviously it's tiny now, so let's stretch that out, make it a little bit larger. Alright, I think that's pretty good looking. So obviously doesn't look too different from this one. But this one is just a bit easier in most cases, assuming that you are using Google Documents. Alright, so that's pretty much all I have to say about results sections. Those are the basics. If you get a results section that looks a bit like this, with plenty of text and a few charts, then that should be perfectly fine for your purposes. Alright.